folks. Just a quick note to tell you how I spent Christmas. I was at Steve's place listening to Kavisha Mazzella CDs. Two of the finest pieces of recorded music ever made in Australia. I can tell you that. And the ARIA people thought so too. They gave her a big award. And she's toured the world. And now she's right here with Dave Steele to give you an intimate concert. So, folks, put your hands together for Kavisha Mazzella. Dave Steele.
Song for my nonna, my Italian grandma, and when she came to Australia, she immigrated to Australia in the early 60s, and my father was teaching her how to speak her first English lessons, and he'd say, okay, good morning, good morning, very good, how are you, how are you, good, 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 thank you, would you like a cup of tea, would you like a cup of tea? Okay, and now you have to make them the cup of tea. What? Every time I say hello to someone, I have to make a cup of tea? This English language is stupid. I'm not learning English. So that was it. Anyhow, this is a song for her called Fisherman's Daughter. Fisherman's daughter, she pulls in the net. Her father showed her how. She's the one he loves the best. She knows the ocean, she knows the wind, and she can track the path of the fallen stars. Tell you where they've been. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah. next song is about falling in love and not wanting to get out of bed for a long time. And you know what, sorry?
That's
right. It's got a whistling bit. If you want to, that'd be good if you could whistle with us, that'd be great. It goes like this. Can't whistle and laugh at the same time, so we've got to get serious now.
She hasn't got a dog, you see.
Okay? Got it? Okay, you do that bit, alright? Lovewrecked and smiling, we emerge from our room in the late afternoon down to the river. There the water swoon, cool and dark, you look at me, then you smile. The trees begin to shimmer. Come on, darling, hold me till it hurts. My lips aching over time, my hands float up your shirt. Come on, darling, we've been so alone. Come here, close that door. Can't get my clothes on fast enough. I wanna kiss you to the
Come on, darling.
and brothers out at sea. One day gives nothing, the next day the nets are bursting. Oh, one will give his life to your wild soul, the ocean. I make a little shrine to put us in your heart, Madonna del Mare, Donna del Mare, Donna del Mare. Sometimes I feel so lonely, terror when he's late. Seagulls wild cry, Norman and children waiting. I see the boat coming. I hear my man's voice. I pray you say, I see you say, grazie, Madonna del Mare. Song is we like to do is a song called Wolf. Got a couple of stories with this song, as most songs do. One of the stories. There is a friend of mine who's been was going through a hard time and he was all strung out on heroin and. And the other story is, when I heard Archie Roach sing for the first time, he said, how can I say that I've suffered more than you? What we've got to ask each other is, how do we survive? So both those sort of things came together, and this is a song that came out. You're not tough, I see you run. drink deep from a incantation through your heart, not with your eyes. To introduce you to one of Australia's fabulous singer-songwriters, and he's got a new album coming up very shortly, and I'm very privileged to be playing with the fabulous, talented Dave Steele, who's now going to sing a song. So please,
thank you.
Thank you.
Scary intro. Yeah, I've been really lucky, eh? And for the last few years I've been able to work with some people that I'm a huge fan of, and Kavisha is one of those people, and Archie Roach is another. Archie and Ruby have put up with me for 2 or 3 years. We've travelled around the world together. And interesting, because I've been in some odd places, but probably the oddest and the most intense was Cape York, and this song comes from up there. I was here earlier on, and this gentleman down here held up a card, said no long introductions. I'm really sorry about this, but this song's got a hell of a long introduction. I'll make it as short as I can, Paul, okay? Okay, Cape York. This song comes from Arukun, which is on the west side of Cape York. And we went up there for 5 weeks, went into several of the communities, and we did concerts and workshops with the kids. And it was a marvellous sort of thing to do. Arukun's on the, as I said, about halfway up on the west side. It's the headquarters of the Wik people, for those of you that don't know that. And so Gladys in the song is the Gladys that danced on the steps of the High Court when the Wik decision, was first handed down. Okay. Wikmonkan is a language they speak up there. It's a composite language. Three tribal groups are brought together by a man named Mackenzie. Now, my mother's name is Mackenzie, so I was sort of, kind of almost proud of this missionary, because he was the only one in the Cape that translated the Gospels into their language. I mean, he was still translating the Gospels, but, you know, it was a step in the right direction, you know. Anyway, the main thing about this song is really about the place more than anything else. And it's a magnificent place. Three huge rivers meet the sea at Arukun. There must be 10,000 acres of mangrove swamps there. Huge flights of birds, crocodiles. Barramundi, out of season, in season, who cares? It's beautiful. So, this is, I just I can go on for hours about the place before I sing the song, and I'm not going to do that because I've seen the direction and I know I'm not supposed to. But just to say this, that if anyone here has got any doubts about this kind of weird issue that's been plaguing this country for the last 200 years, go up there and talk to Gladys. See what you think then. Okay, this is called Arukun Moon. Beside the airfield, we camped behind the school. Green ants crawling in my head. I stared at the sunset like a fool. And that Arukun moon shine up above. If I miss my plane, I know that Arukun moon shine on just to see. Gladys dancing in the dust, a little Lil, she runs around. Friday's always payday. There's a great big party in the town. Just like Trench Town in North Queensland. The sound system beats compete up the dusty street. And the heat haze shimmers where the three rivers meet. All the boys, they shook my hand, they said, hey, you're pretty good, bruh. And they staggered up onto the stage. They played Wipeout like there was no tomorrow. And that Arukun moon shined up above. Took me on the river. We talked history and I laughed and turned and watched the moon set on the old Gulf water. And a fireball sun was rising in the east. And he ran me up the river, yeah, where the ancient mangroves dream. And we listen to the sound of the Delta breathing. So much beauty makes my heart ache, that's true. I wish you could be here. You listen to
Shakespeare. And the language sounded like the country. They all out singing all night with an island drum. How can our people be so strong? Suffer thus and still overcome must be that Arukun Moon. And it shine up above. Same old moon. If I should miss my plane, I know that Arukun Moon will shine on just the same. Just the same.
Thank you.
Well, the only way you can, the only song you can do out of that is something completely different, like a Neapolitan song. So this is a song called Angellare, and it tells a story of a girl who's been stolen, and her name's Angellare, and her mother's searching for her, and she says, over land, over sea, I'll never tire until I find my Angellare. And in the end, she concedes, in defeat, she says, I can't find her, I just want to die. And if you see that Ingrata, you tell him I'm singing this. And it goes like this.
Sabia
say last year anymore, or the year before last, I got a chance to work in a play. Yeah, I got a job. I got a job for 8 whole weeks. As a musician, you can imagine this is a miracle. Working in a play, and the job was to write some songs for this play called Waterfront Women. And it was a little show that we put on in West Australia in Fremantle, in the port there, a little theatre company called Deck Chair Theatre Company. And I was talking to the director about it, Angellare Chaplin, and I said, Waterfront Women? I never heard of such a thing, Waterfront Women. She goes, yeah, you know, the wives, the barmaids, the prostitutes, and the support crew. So I wrote this song for the support crew. And it goes like this. And that's also the place where, if you had a smart car, that's the place to show it off. And so this is a song about coffee, cars, and Italo-Australian mating rituals. Your nose is too young to smoke cigarettes. If Papa saw her, he'd beat her and send her to bed. My mama says it's not right to be on South Terrace tonight. Yeah, would it be on South Terrace tonight? She's teased at my head. Put out. Oh, you put me off now.
He's barely one of those.
I recognise you. She's teased at my head. She's painted her nails. Put on her makeup. And platform shoes. Checked in the mirror, see she's okay. For the boys on South Terrace tonight, yeah. For the boys on South Terrace tonight. You have some meeting call of his V8. A song called Gypsy Song. I wrote this after I saw that film, Lacho Drum, the first one. Have you seen Gajo Dilo, the next one?
Yeah.
It's great. great, huh? Bloody fantastic. So this song also was inspired from the experience of being kicked out of three houses in a very short amount of time. Three houses in 3 months. Incredible. So I like to dedicate this to anyone who's having a terrible time with your landlord.
Thank you. Kavisha Mazzella, ladies and gentlemen.
We'll see you tomorrow. Thank you. Beats traditional music. So I'd like to sing you a song that I first heard when I was 14. I had this best friend, and her parents were what I wanted my parents to be. They were artists and terribly bohemian. I thought, now when I look back, I think my parents are pretty eccentric. But at the time, I thought they were very conservative. But my parents had a food business, you know, they worked 7 days a week. They never had time to listen to records. But this family, I thought, were terribly amazing because they had time to listen to Fairport Convention records. And anyhow, first time I heard this song was She Moves Through the Fair by Sandy Denny. So it was very inspiring to me, and I thought, I want to do that when I grow up. I want to tune my guitar when I grow up. Okay, it's coming, it's coming.
Oh,
time.